Lay down your sweet and weary head. Night is falling. You've come to Jenny's end. Sleep now. Dream of the ones who came before. From across the distant shore, why do you weep? What are these tears upon your face? Soon you will see all of your fears will pass away, safe in my.
And then you pull. You push, then you pull.
I'm pushing.
Push. Give it a push. Push, then pull.
I'm pushing.
Pull.
I'm trying.
Give it that.
No, I got it.
You got it. You better get it. Deck. Yeah, deck.
Sits on the front porch swinging, looking out on a vacant field. Used to be filled with burlap tobacco, now he knows that it never will. My brother found work in Indiana, sister's a nurse at the old folks' home. Mama's still cooking too much for supper. Me, I've been a long time gone. I've been a long time gone. No, I ain't rode a roll since I don't know when. Long time gone.
Sing her songs. Cause I'm better. That's why.
No, 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 no. No.
And the band plays on and the beer it flows. The boss man's yelling but we've all gone home. Monday morning I will return. But tonight ain't Monday, it's Friday. Yeah, yeah.
It's Thursday. Not Freddy! Start her up!
Hey, give me the people so free my soul. I wanna get lost in your rock and roll and drift away. Day after day I'm...
So wake me up when it's all over.
trick-or-treating to your shoe here. And it is Friday, you dickhead. I looked at me dragon court calendar this morning. Rocked me mama like a wedding wing. Pure crap. I knew you have a dragon court calendar. Dragon court calendar, everybody's got one. If you spend over £10 in dragon court, you get a free bottle of Coke and a free dragon court calendar. Ha! I have it hanging in my room.
Well, I know what I'm getting for dinner. A nice sweet calendar.
Ruling titles. A nice sweet calendar, that's true.
Is it?
We bears on it.
The bargain is at 6 o'clock.
Hello, I'm Jimmy McVeigh.
And I'm Doug O'Doherty.
Welcome to the Ballyhargan at 6 o'clock news. It is 9. Well, it's 5:00, Doug.
Oh, wait a minute, wait, Jimmy.
We might as well. Is there any good in that district, Doodle?
Nothing. But look at this. Duffy's are doing a sale on vodka for £13.
That's cheap. I've seen cheaper, Doodle.
Where?
Someone who works in the belfry. Good close friend of mine. It's 9:00.
And these are stories making the headlines tonight.
All clear.
Good. I would need to go put on a pair of trousers, Doodle. Well, draft. That would put you off loving never mind your dinner. Jimmy, where'd you get them boxers?
Have the guys that went on a trip around the world come back to their farmer? The Ballyhargan people are living in fear after hearing some bad news. And in sport, Kevin Lynch has had a very successful 2013 season. What do you think, Joe?
That's all coming up on the Ballyhargan news.
Remember the cows when the trip around the world with the tail and the farmer? Well, they're back.
Oh my god!
I know. But their trip was cut short. But why? Jimmy McVeigh has more in the story.
All clear.
Who says, oh my god, when I'm man news reading? Is that you? Don't do that.
I am here. I am here in the field where the cows have Diggle! Where's the cows?
Jimmy! You're there! How am I meant to know?
There's nothing here but grass, Diggle!
Right! What colour's the grass?
It's a greeny browny colour, Diggle!
Jimmy! That's cow feces! So they must be there!
Diggle, they're not here!
What's the feces like, Jimmy?
It's alright, it's drying outside, but it's wet inside!
Ha! Giggity! But don't eat that Jimmy, that's Guy Pip. Them cows are long gone.
Right, so there's no story here at all. So I got myself wet for nothing, Douglas. Is that what you're trying to tell me? I'm Jimmy McVie reporting for the Ballyhargan News. It's time for the sport with Jigaloo Dorty.
And sports night! Kevin Knight's hurling! Jeez, that's a nice hurler, boys! Kevin Lynch has had a fantastic 2013 season as they won the under 16 and the minor county championships. They beat the Balubas in the final. Well, I may say, hammered them in the final. Dickie Ward must have been right when he said,
"We are the best."
Now I've got Joe Brolly in the studio here with me. Joe, what do you think of Kevin Lynch's success throughout last year?
Well, you know, I want nothing to do with that, quite honestly.
Why?
It's a disgrace.
Why?
I think it's absolutely disgraceful.
Why?
You know, Bigger, you know, and Declan Ward, you know, jumping up and down and cheering and smiling and going on, and you know, as if they've achieved something good. I tell you what they've achieved. They've achieved something absolutely rotten. And they're becoming a template for clubs and for counties all over the country now. Young teams going out, an under 16 match on Wednesday night. Two sweepers methodically pulling down the opposing team as they're coming up the field. This is how you do it to get the job done. This is your new language. The euphemism for cheating is closing the game out.
But you,
hold on a minute. Now, that, what Aidan Duddy did, I cannot believe that somebody awarded him the man of the match. That was a total and absolute disgrace. That's the antithesis, hold on, of what Gaelic games are about. You're supposed to be able to look your opponent in the face. What do we teach kids?
I don't know. Mass?
Respect for yourself. Respect for your opponent. I take an under 12 team. If any of them did that, they wouldn't play for the team again. And yet,
hang on, you.
Hold on. Yeah, this is being touted around the country. And people are saying things like, "Oh, that's within the rules, you're not..." It's within the rules! You're not supposed to rub your tackles up for someone from behind. I was a total disgrace. Now, I'll tell you something else about it. I mean, no one stood up for Kevin Lynch's in the 2000s that I have in this studio when they were getting all sorts of abuse from you and from you, cameraman.
Why? What did he do? What did you do?
Ah, you. But I'll tell you this, I'll not be standing up for that. It was a total and absolute disgrace. And the casual way that it's done last week they dragged the young Schwatcher man down when he was through. Drag him down! That's how you do it, that's how it's done. The young Schwatcher man got the goal because he escaped the rugby tackle. Today, Aidan Duddy, he was a brilliant hurler. But I'll tell you what, you forget about Aidan Duddy as far as he's a man. What he did there today was a total and absolute disgrace.
In the come on now, Joe, I support Kevin Lynch.
No, hold on. Just let me finish here. Joe Bradley gets the ball. He thinks to himself, "I can break through here, I can score a goal." He shows a sense of adventure. He beats the first man, he's through. What happens? He's just dragged down to the ground. And I'll tell you what, the black card's only the start, the start of an urgent, an absolutely urgent process that's required. There was no sport, no other sport, apart from Gaelic games, where that is permitted. As a total, absolute disgrace. I tell you, I want nothing. I want nothing to do with that.
But Joe, do you not think...
tell you what, I won't be standing up for that there. That right there is an absolute total disgrace. That is rotten. Sitting there, he is rotten. That's a total and absolute disgrace.
Finally tonight, the Ballyhargan citizens are living in fear. Why? I'll tell you why. Local farmers' hands have escaped. Now they just aren't any hands. These are killer hands. It's said to believe that these hands are quick on their feet, hungry, and very, very dangerous. The Prime Minister of Ballyhargan said out a quote this morning saying, "Lock up all windows and doors and run like hell." Our own Dougal Doherty is at the scene.
All clear.
A story about dangerous hands. Hands! Dangerous! Who writes this stuff? Pure crap! Yes, Jimmy, I am here in Ballyhargan, where people are getting ready for war. I was along with a local mother this morning to see what she had to say about the hens.
There's always something, isn't there? Always something here in Ballyhargan. You know, there's DVDs going missing, and then there's, you have the rabbits being slaughtered, and now this. You know, we can't live in peace in here. Can we not live in harmony here in Ballyhargan? You know, that local farmer, he should have them hens locked down behind a fence. You know what I mean?
The hens flew over the fence.
Hens can fly. You know, it's on you every day. Listen, but stop. He should be locked away, I think. Oh, hello, Patricia. How are you? Oh, are you well? Oh, that's great. And how's Jack? Oh, Jack's good. That's great. And what do you think about these hands? Eh? Some crack, isn't it? I know, we can't live in peace, can we not? All right, I'll see you later. Tell Jack is asking about him. All right. That's Patricia. She's some crack. She's white crack. What's in hands? I would see that farmer. He should be locked up. He should be jailed, he should be sued, he should be sawn, because I have got 12 children in here. I have 5 boys and 2 girls in here. And when they get scared, they are shivering with fear in here. And when they get scared, when they have nightmares, I put on Peter Pan for them. And they watch that and that calms them down. That's enough pain watching Peter Pan today, and they haven't calmed down, so they haven't. You know, and what am I meant to do? I haven't even got watching it yet. It's not fair. And look, Patricia. Patricia's been eaten. So she has by hands, and you're sitting there. Jesus Christ.
Jeez, that woman is mental. I'd be scared of her before them bloody hands. Dougal, get yourself back to the studio before you get a kicking.
I'm scared of no hands. You know, if a hand came up to me, you know what I'd do this? You know what I did is, I'd left his back to you and I'd kick it fair in the scrotum. It wouldn't be so big then, would it? I would sort him out.
The citizens of Ballyhargan are getting ready for World War 3, as you might say. Men, women and children and even animals are fighting against one another just to survive. I was along with some other citizens who had their view on the hens. What do you think of the hens, sir?
The hens took me house!
And what do you plan to do about it?
What am I gonna do? What am I gonna do? I'll tell you what I'm gonna do! They may take our lives! They may even take me Doritos! They may even go into my bottom cupboard under the sink and take me to digestive biscuits! But I'll tell you what they won't take! They won't take me bucking house!
He's a nice fella. The people here are mental.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, cats and dogs, we would like to thank you, well, myself and Dougal would like to thank you, the public, for tuning in to watch the Ballyhargan News from episode 1 right up to 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10 episodes. And some other bonus stuff in between. We We would like to thank you.
It has been a very emotional journey we've had. We've had our ups, we've had our downs, we've had our verticals, we had everything. But we had mostly ups, I think. What do you think?
We definitely had ups. There were some downs, but the ups were good.
Yes.
The ups were good.
Yes.
Definitely. Yes.
But we'd especially like to thank you for tuning in to watch this very last episode of the Ballyhargan News. I promised myself I wouldn't cry.
Don't cry. I'm hiding it in. You can do it too, with can do. Nathan Carter and Derek Ryan were supposed to do the closing of the show, but they're critically ill in McGilvin with serious injuries to their head after a massive fight broke out backstage.
I told you to leave them alone, Jim.
I know you did, I just couldn't. They were just so annoying and horrible. Their music is so horrible, I just couldn't not punch them in the face.
Well, I enjoyed it.
I didn't.
Okay. But anyway, instead of them playing in the studio, here's a short video of clips from each episode 1 to 10. Enjoy.
You should give them some kicking. There's a lot of blood tree. They must be.
Written in these walls are the stories that I can't explain. I leave my heart open, but it stays right here empty for days. She told me in the morning she don't feel the same about us in her bones. Seems to me that when I die, these words will be written on my stone. And I'll be gone, gone tonight. The ground beneath my feet is open wide. The way that I've been holding on too tight, with nothing in between.
Story of my life, I take you home. I travel night to keep a warm inside. It's
stays right here in its cage. I know that in the morning now, see us in the light upon the hill. Although I am broken, my heart is unchained still. And I'll be gone, gone tonight. Fire beneath my feet is burning bright. The way that I've been holding so tight, but nothing in between. It's like chasing the clouds. The story of my life, I take her home. I drive all night to keep her warm, and time is frozen.
I drive all night to keep her warm.
that's good, wouldn't it?